San Silvestro in Capite. Oh, there's a church here. Altar. Several rows of pews are here, provided for the faithful to park their rears on during Mass. A huge ornate altar takes up the center of the church. You never did feel comfortable in these types of big churches. Statue. On the side of the altar is a statue of the Madonna and Child. Alright, anything else? Angel lamp. One of the two lamps, shaped like an angel, holds a lantern, which provides some illumination in this place. The priest is standing by the altar, reading a book. Let's talk to him.
This is a really nice church you've got here.
Thank you. That means quite a lot to me.
Let's ask him a question.
Excuse me, Father?
Yes, my child.
Yes, my child.
My name is Ben Jordan, and I was wondering if I could ask you a few questions.
A pleasure, Mr. Jordan. I'm Father Eamon McNamara, and I'll be glad to help you in any way I can.
Tell me about the murder.
I was hoping you could tell me about the recent murder of a priest named Thomas Ryan.
I'm sure I have no idea what you're talking about. We have no one by that name at this church.
Really?
Really? Because I found out about this place by looking up his name.
Well, there must be some kind of mistake then. I can assure you, there's never been a priest named Thomas Ryan at San Silvestro.
Tell about yourself.
Tell me about yourself, Father.
What would you like to know?
Well, I couldn't help but notice your accent.
Ah, yes.
Irish.
You're probably wondering what an Irish priest is doing in a Roman church. San Silvestro is run by Irish Palatines, and is actually one of the few primarily English-speaking churches in Rome. I moved here from Dublin about 5 years ago, and have been employed at this church ever since.
What can you tell me about San Silvestro in Capite?
Well, quite a bit. This church has a long and interesting history. Originally, it was built in the 8th century, over the ruins of a pagan temple dedicated to Apollo. The church has been rebuilt several times over the centuries, but still serves its original purpose.
And what might that be?
Well, to house relics. In fact, the words In Capite in our church's name refer to our most famous relic, a fragment of the head of John the Baptist.
You don't say.
Interesting. Relics.
Call me ignorant, but what exactly is a relic?
A relic is an object of religious significance, usually a body part of a saint or something similar. They're of great importance to many religions. In Christianity, there are three levels of relic classification. A class 3 relic is an object that was either touched by a saint or put near the shrine built for a saint. A class 2 relic is an object that a saint carried with him, like a cross or an item of clothing. A first class relic is the most important kind. These are either items directly associated with the life of Christ or the physical remains of a saint.
So you're talking about stuff like the Shroud of Turin?
Exactly. The Shroud of Turin, pieces of the true cross, the Holy Prepuce.
Holy Prepuce?
The remains of Jesus' foreskin from when he was circumcised.
What?
You mean, that actually
exists?
Seriously
now.
Theoretically. Of course, who actually has it is open for debate.
So people collect this stuff?
No, only churches are permitted to have relics. There's plenty of people out there who want them, no doubt. But I imagine that a relic in the wrong hands could have serious consequences.
What sort of consequences?
Yeah. Oh, nothing worth talking about.
Okay. Demons.
Do you know anything about demons?
That's a tricky subject. But yes, I do know a few things about demons. Generally, a demon is an evil spirit or a fallen angel, which can possess humans and make them do all sorts of wicked things. If this happens, an exorcist is called in to expel the demon.
Is that a common practice these days? I mean, I saw the movie.
It isn't very common, no. But it's not unheard of. Have you ever heard of the Gospel of Mark?
No, I dropped out of Sunday school.
Well, that gospel talks about Jesus as an exorcist. He healed people and got rid of their demons in the days before his death.
I had no idea.
What about murder again?
Are you sure you don't know anything about Thomas Ryan's murder?
It's as I said, Mr. Jordan. We have no one by that name at this church.
Interesting. What about murder?
Are you sure you don't know anything about Thomas Ryan's murder?
It's as I said, Mr. Jordan. We have no one by that name at this church.
Well, let's say goodbye.
I'll see you later, Father.
God be with you.
Okay, thank you. Save our progress as church. Don't want to touch anything right now. It's too sacred. let's get on our way.